स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट लेसन 6 चेंजेस अराउंड अस। इन द प्रीवियस डिस्कशन वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट चेंजेस अराउंड अस, स्लो एंड फास्ट चेंजेस, फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंजेस, रिवर्सिबल एंड इरिवर्सिबल चेंजेस। टुडे वी विल लर्न एक्सपेंशन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्शन, एक्सपेंशन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इन सॉलिड्स, एक्सपेंशन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इन गैसेस एंड रिविजन ऑफ द लेसन। नेक्स्ट इज द एक्सपेंशन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्शन। सो वॉट इज एन एक्सपेंशन? व्हेन वी हीट समथिंग इट एक्सपेंड्स एंड द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस एक्सपेंड और बिकम लूज। So when we heat something, the size of the substance increases and its particles, they expand or become increase in size. This process is known as expansion. Similarly, what is a contraction? When we cool something, it contracts and the particles of a substance contract or become tight. Size of the substance decreases. This process is known as contraction. So, we mostly observe that gases expand the most when heated and solids expand least. Similarly, gases contract the most when cooled and solids contract least. It means gases expand the most as well as also contract the most, and the solids, they expand least as well as they also contract least. So it is essential to know how much a material expands or contracts due to changes in the weather conditions. So when an overhead cable is suspended between the two poles, so what will you observe? So it is left slack, it is left loose to allow for contraction in winter and expansion in the summer to avoid the contact of the two wires of the pole. Similarly, in the railway lines, gaps are left. Why? To allow their expansion in the hot weather and contraction in the cold weather. So these gaps are known as the expansion gaps. So it means when we heat something, the substance increases in size, or when we cool something, the substance, it decreases in size or become tight. So to understand the expansion and contraction, we will perform two experiments: expansion and contraction in solids. First of all, we will try to understand how expansion and contraction occurs in solids. To show that solids expand when heated and contract when cooled. So for this, there is a requirement of metal ball. So this is a metal ball, metal ring. So this is a metal ring with handle and a heating device. So we will introduce the metal ball through the metal ring at the room temperature. What will we observe? We will observe that it will pass through the metal ring. Now we will heat the metal wall. When we will heat, size of the metal wall increases in size. It will expand, and due to which when we also try to pass it through the metal ring next time, it will not pass through the metal ring. Why? Because the size of the metal ring expands in size, increases in size, and it can't pass through the metal ring. So after that, we will cool the metal wall. We will cool the metal wall at the room temperature, and when we will allow to cool it at the room temperature, it will decreases in size and it will pass through the metal ring. So these experiments show that solids expand on heating and contract on cooling. Now the next experiment to understand how expansion and contraction occur in the gases. So for this, materials that is required: two balls, two balloons, two bottles, a long thread and water. We will take two balls. So for this purpose we will pour some ice cold water in one bowl and some hot water in another bowl. So we will take two inflated balloons, phule hue balloons, and tie these balloons to the neck of the bottles with a thread. So we will tie these inflated balloons with the neck of the bottle. Keep one bottle with the inflated balloon in ice cold water and the another bottle with inflated balloon in the hot water. So what will we observe? So we will observe that due to the contraction of air, inflated balloon in the ice cold water decreases in size and the bund kept in the hot water increases in size due to the expansion of the air. Size of the balloon in the ice cold water decreases because the air in the balloon contracts on cooling, and in the hot water the size of the balloon increases because the air in the balloon expands on heating. So in this way we can understand expansion and contraction in solids as well as in the gases. Now let's revise the lesson. So we have learned in this lesson what is a change. Change is an act by which anything becomes different than its previous self. So thing becomes different than its previous self. So some changes are physical. What are the physical changes? In which no new substances form. For example, melting of ice. When the ice melts, there is a formation of water. So water is the change form of the ice and ice. So in this way, so both ice and water are water, and there is no change in only in the form. Some are the chemical in which new substances are formed. So what are the chemical changes in which new substances are formed? For example, curdling of milk. When we convert milk into the curd, so what happens? There is a formation of a new substance, curd. So new substance, that is a chemical change. Some are slow and some are fast. For example, aging is a slow change, and what is a fast change? Burning of crackers is a fast change. Some are reversible, that can be reversed, like melting of ice. So it is a physical as well as reversible change. Some are irreversible, like curdling of milk. So curdling of milk is a chemical as well as irreversible change, because when we convert milk into the curd, we can't get milk back from the curd. So these are the curdling of milk is a irreversible change. On heating, materials show expansion. When the materials are heated, they increase in size and they show expansion. On cooling, they show contraction. So we have understood in this lesson, gases expand the most when heated and solids expand the least when heated. So hope you all have understood this lesson. So it is clear. If you have any doubt or the query, you can talk me later. You can call me anytime. So thank you. Okay, bye. Have a nice day.